Good afternoon, everyone. Good afternoon, staff, students, parents, visitors. Welcome to our 2014 Dr. Martin Luther King Kindness Inspires Kindness Celebration. Today's celebration, boys and girls, is a way to remember and say thank you to Dr. King for many of his contributions. Boys and girls, I also realize that you are too young to have, and were not around to have known Dr. King, too young to have stood on the steps of Lincoln Memorial to hear his I Have a Dream speech, too young and not around to march with Dr. King and others in pursuit of freedom, justice, and equality, and too young to have joined the world to mourn his loss. But I am glad to know that you are old enough, to keep Dr. King's dream and legacy alive. You know, boys and girls, and I know you see me every single day, and I enjoy seeing you every single day. One of the joys that I have as being principal of King Arts is noticing the random acts of kindness that I see from you every single day. Just the other day, I watched a third grader help a first grader get to the main office because the first grader was upset about losing their backpack. I noticed a first grader helping another first grader tie his shoes, or a third grader stopping to help one of our teachers carry several packages to the classroom. And boys and girls, they got a lot of stuff coming in the office, boxes and stuff for you, so that you can benefit from your learning experience. These random acts of kindness are exactly what we're looking for at King Arts. Students, being kind is so important to mankind today. I know that sometimes you might see something bad on TV, something bad outside, even something bad at school. But one of the ways we can turn something bad into something good is showing others what it means to be kind, what it means to be thoughtful, what it means to be caring, what it means to be a friend, what it means to make good choices, and what it means to be a beautiful person like Dr. King. Like you boys and girls, Dr. King was once a kid. He enjoyed playing games with his friends, helping other people, his classmates, teachers, helping, sharing stories with friends, maybe on their way to the park or when they're at the library. As young people, please continue to be caring and thoughtful individuals. Because this is the 50th anniversary, boys and girls, and I know that Miss Edens talked about this yesterday with our middle schoolers, for the next 50 school days, I would like to recognize students over the PA system for their random acts of kindness. So in the morning, and instead of Dr. Brown saying, students, remember to be and then staff and students have a wonderful day, right? I'd like to be able to say, students, remember, kindness inspires kindness. Let's try that one. All right, wait. Remember.
Kindness inspires kindness.
I'm loving it already. Sounds good. For 50 days. 50 days. And I'm going to get on that PA system. We're going to do our announcements. I'm going to brag about each and every one of you, okay? I'm going to ask teachers to give me names. I'm going to ask your classmates to give me names. I'm going to ask you to give me names so I can at least mention those students over the PA system for the next 50 days. On behalf of Ms. Edens and I, we would like to thank the staff for keeping the life and legacy of Dr. King alive through education. Students, we'd like to thank you for being such a loving group of individuals. Parents, thank you. And I always say this, and I truly believe it. As for parents, aunts, uncles, grandparents, thank you very much for raising your kids, your child, the right way. It makes a tremendous difference here at King Arts, and that's why we are beautiful and a special place where kids can be safe and enjoy learning. Once again, thank you very much.
Good afternoon. My name is Jamie Cortegrosa, and I am the drama teacher here at King Arts and the head of the Fine Arts Department. And it's my pleasure to welcome you again to this wonderful celebration of our namesake, Dr. Martin Luther King, Jr. Today, we're going to begin our celebration in the way that we've begun this celebration since we've been doing this since 1969. And that is with the song, Lift Every Voice and Sing. This song was written for a birthday of our president, Abraham Lincoln. And it's been sung at many concerts and festivals and celebrations, but it's especially important because it talks about how we can continue the hope that one day everyone will be free and we will live in a just world. So I'm going to welcome to the stage now our middle school chorus, our only middle school performers in this assembly, to lead us in the song, Lift Every Voice and Sing. And I will now ask you to open up your programs, and you'll see inside of your programs the chorus to Lift Every Voice and Sing. I ask you to please stand as we sing this song.
Good afternoon. Good afternoon, children and parents. Welcome. This is the kindergarten class here at King Arts. They prepared a couple selections for you all. The first selection that they will be doing is their Pledge of Allegiance. Now, it is a song that they have learned and that they're going to sing for you all. We have a kindergarten integration program here where I will come into the classroom or try to incorporate some musical things that pertain to what they are learning in their regular curriculum. And one of the teachers came and asked if there was a song for the Pledge of Allegiance. And I didn't have one. And I went and did some research and found one. And this is a way that we just reaffirm what they're learning in the classroom and that they add music to it, they can remember it, and they've been singing it. Have any kids been singing the Pledge of Allegiance song at home?
Yep.
You wouldn't sound too enthusiastic about that. But since you are familiar with it, you can sing along with them. So please welcome the kindergarten class here at King Arts.
Thank you.
require your help. This song is a call and response song, so our kids will sing a phrase to you and you will have a response to them, okay? So first, I'm going to have you guys practice with me so that they can see what's going to happen, okay? You guys know that everybody ought to know, right?
Yeah.
Okay, because we've been practicing.
Yeah.
All right, are you ready?
Yeah.
drum roll. I can't find a lot of my brother. Thank you guys so much.
Sam Nichols is our second grade. Our second graders here at King Arts, and they have a wonderful presentation for you. The song that we sing is called Heal the World by Michael Jackson, and we're going to have Andy Martin with you. All right. Here we go.
Yeah. We are going to play a song written in 1968 following the passage of the Civil Rights Movement. And this song is a tribute to some important figures in American history and important figures in the Civil Rights Movement. I think you will recognize them when you hear them, their names. The song was originally recorded by Dion, some of you are old enough to remember Dion, and also some famous covers by Smokey Robinson and Marvin Gaye. Third grade.
Yeah.
Again, how about them getting on the stage? And not playing their recorders. So our next song, we're going to feature another song from the time period of the Civil Rights Movement. This song, Keep On Pushing, by Curtis Mayfield and the Impressions, Chicago's very own, was written in 1964 and was a top 10 hit. And it was recorded several weeks before the passage of the Civil Rights Act. So it's kind of got big significance there. It became an inspirational anthem of the Civil Rights Movement. It was sung at many marches and rallies. So we're also going to be featuring their recorder playing, which they learned last year and rejuvenated this year, as you might remember trying to find those recorders back in September. So they'll be playing, featuring their recorder skills as well as their vocal skills. Highlighting their music both today and yesterday. Chicago's staple singers came from a gospel tradition, but blended rhythm blues, funk, and rock and roll, jazz, and blues, and came up with kind of their own unique take on gospel music. So we're going to be featuring a song of theirs called Respect Yourself, which became an inspirational song during the period of the early 1970s, just after the Civil Rights Act was passed and all of the important events of the 1960s. This course, we're also going to be featuring our rock ensemble over here. And Because I'll be doing double duty, Alexis Harris, our singer, will be helping out with conducting our choristers, and the rock ensemble is uniquely featuring five saxophones, mandolin, bass, and drums. Possibly the first time those instruments have been put together. I'm not sure if that's ever been done before, so.
Thank you.
ensemble one more time. This song will feature our singer Alexis Harris Dyer. A great song, also by Staple Singers. This is I'll Take You There. And the message of this song really closely reflects the spirit and message of Dr. King's I Have a Dream speech.
Rehearsal yesterday, and then got on stage and learned the dance from your children. So it was a wonderful, wonderful moment. Today what you'll hear, this is unrehearsed. We have a live drummer today. Jamie Berkman will be running us in our parade. And this is the first grade, When I Get Older, I Will Be Strong. Thank you.
they are going to be our leaders for our final song, which we're all going to sing together. But before we do that, I would just like to take a moment to let you know that Evanston Community Television is taping our event. And this will be on Channel 19 in a couple of weeks. Oh. I think the fourth grade was excited about that. Have a seat, please. All right, let's continue. I jumped up. Sorry. Let's bring it back. Good. Thank you. Also, there's a lot of kids behind the stage who, if we do our job right, you don't even know that we're there in the sound and the lights and moving all of the risers and curtains around. They'll come out at the end while we're singing, so you can give them a hand then, a group of fifth through eighth graders. And I just want to thank Dr. Brown and Miss Edens, our fabulous principals who constantly support us. Thank you so much. You're going to hear about our fine arts staff after that, after we finish today. So that's, I think, all I wanted to say. And I also wanted to thank, she's going to get mad at me for this, but Alderman Ann Rainey from the 8th Ward for coming by today. Thanks so much. We appreciate you being here. Since we come from all over the wards of Evanston here at King Arts. Okay, so we are going to finish our assembly this year with the song that we use every year as well. It's our tradition to end with this song, which is another call to hope, a call to hope and change, and we call it We Shall Overcome. So we ask you now to stand up and hold hands.
We shall King Arts community, something that they can remember forever.
listening to you sing. I'm telling you, I was moved in the back. Brought tears to my eyes because I can feel the love and the joy that's in this auditorium. And that's what I feel every single day when I come to work. So I'm going to ask the following staff member to come out. Let's thank them. Let's give them a round of applause. Mr. Smith, what a great thing. I want to thank my stage crew.